Welcome back. Our top story, and Jerry Sandusky just left the courthouse for the day. It wrapped up today. Today is day three, and the jury heard more graphic and disturbing testimony from some of the alleged victims in the Jerry Sandusky sex abuse case. Three accusers took the stand. In Sessions, Beth Karras is following this case from Pennsylvania. And Beth, it must be so difficult for these alleged victims to get up there and say what they went through during that time with Jerry Sandusky. How do they seem on the stand?
Well, good afternoon. It is indeed difficult and seems to be more difficult for some of them. This afternoon, yet another one of these alleged victims testified and broke down on the stand as he recounted the one incident from August 2001. He's known as victim number five. He's now 23 years old. His parents were in the courtroom along with his lawyer. He told about one incident and one incident only in August of 2001. Although he did drive in a car with Sandusky and Sandusky had his hand on his thigh, the actual touching, the unlawful conduct, the crime occurred, he says, in the showers at the Lash Building on the campus of Penn State University about 6 months after the McCreary incident, after Sandusky had been told not to bring boys into the showers anymore. So this is August 2001. He said that he was invited to the sauna after working out with Sandusky. And in the sauna, he became quite uncomfortable. He was almost 13. He was 12 years old at the time. And Sandusky unwrapped the towel from himself and exposed himself to this boy. It made him very uncomfortable. And after that, they went into the showers. And he went up to the wall on the far end of the showers. There are several shower heads in there. And he faced the wall. He wanted to get away from Sandusky. And as he told the story about this incident, he definitely was reliving it, because he spoke in a halting way. He started to cry. He pulled out a handkerchief. He was wiping his eyes. He was blowing his nose. He was the little boy again. He said, I was aware that he was behind me. I was looking over my shoulder. It seemed like it took forever. But what he described was Sandusky with an erection. He said, I didn't understand what it meant, but he pressed up against him and then reached around and grabbed his genitals. Mm-hmm. It seemed like it lasted forever. That was the extent of it. There was no other, like, oral sex or anything like that. He was able to get away. Sandusky drove him home. He comes from a nice home with parents. That was the only incident he talked about. He basically is here to talk about his own incident, but to corroborate the others. He was found by the police.
Sorry, Beth, the details are just so graphic. When you see these accusers on the stand, are they looking directly at Jerry Sandusky? Are they avoiding eye contact? And how is Jerry Sandusky responding to these stories?
He was avoiding him. From what I could see, he was avoiding him. Although he would have to look in his direction to address Joe Amendola, who for this witness was seated to the witness's left and to the right of Sandusky. There wasn't that much cross-examination of him, though. There wasn't too much to impeach him with. And in fact, his attorney, Tom Klein, did have a few words to say about his client and that outside of court. Let's listen to what his attorney had to say. It works.
He came forward, he put his hand on a Bible in a courtroom, he looked at 12 strangers on a jury, and he told them, this happened to me. And I heard literally no cross-examination on anything of substance as to what he had to say. I think what he said today was unassailed, unassailable, and unimpeachable, and the story becomes stronger every day.
His client, victim number five, also said that for years he didn't tell anyone what had happened to him that day in the shower. It wasn't until he had a girlfriend years later. She was the first person that he told.
Beth, in your experience, is this trial going along at kind of the normal pace? And how is the judge, in your opinion, handling all of this?
Well, This case is moving along actually faster than expected. In fact, at the end of the day today, the judge told the jury that the prosecution is going to rest by Friday. And he excused the jury for the day an hour earlier rather than start another witness because, you know, they have heard testimony about 7 of the 10 victims. The jury has now heard about alleged victims 2 and 8. Those are the 2 unidentified victims, so the testimony is coming in to prove the crimes associated with them from other witnesses. So they heard from a janitor today regarding this number 8, and they heard, of course, from Mike McCreary and his father regarding number 2. So 7 victims have been testified to, have testified or been testified about. 3 more are left. 3, 6, and 9 are the ones that are left. They will get through this case by the end of the week.
Wow, it seems to be going along fairly quickly, as you said, which is a good thing for the alleged victims here. Beth Karras, thank you. Great job outside of the courthouse.